move to our final speaker, Professor Kostas Douzinas. Kostas Douzinas is Professor of Law at Birkbeck College, University of London. He was a member of the Hellenic Parliament from 2015 to 2019, and he was also President of the Foreign Relations and Defense Committee of the Greek Parliament. His latest book include Radical Philosophy of Rights, and in Greek, Apo Tin Edra Sta Edrana, Erga Ki Meres Mias Aristeris Kibernesis, from the academic chair, I suppose, to the benches of Parliament. Please to introduce Professor Douzinas. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Alexandre, Maria, Dimitri, and all the wonderful speakers we had earlier. And good evening to you all, wherever you are. In this rather weird conjuncture, we appear as shadows on the screen, a voice without body, a ghost. And we hope to put away, I suppose, the evil ghost of the Golden Dome. Now, we had a number of really great presentations. So, me as the last one, I'm going to make three short, more general comments, which I think touch upon directly or indirectly to a number of points made earlier. First, the Nuremberg moment. Now, yesterday was the 75th anniversary of the end of the Nuremberg Tribunal, the most important trial of the 20th century. It was indeed a turning point in our legal civilization. It created the concept of crimes against humanity. It led to the creation of the crime of genocide, and of course helped the rise of the human rights movement. Now, the verdict of the Golden Dawn trial was also described as historic. Is it? Now, it is indeed the first time since Nuremberg that a European so-called political party and the leaders were found to be a murderous criminal gang. Despite the wealth of evidence, the trial lasted for 4.5 years, despite its meticulous conduct, the verdict was not given. It was not necessary that the defendants would be convicted. Indeed, the public prosecutor asked for the acquittal of the leadership of Golden Dawn. She reminded us, in other words, that we live in an age where the microfascism of the next door, the xenophobia of the homemaker, the nikokireos, the racist and conspiracy theorists have backers in the deep state and the law. They were those people who did not initiate criminal proceedings until the murder of Pavlos Fissas. They were those people who wanted to see a Golden Dawn as a serious party, and Maria mentioned that earlier, but that was always a kind of narrative in the right-wing conversation, that Golden Dawn members would abandon their boots, their uniforms, their violence, and become fascists in Armani suits and power dresses, like Salvini and Le Pen. It did not work, of course, but Golden Dawn's great success, it is that it moved the entire political spectrum towards the right wing. This is the evil legacy of Golden Dawn, and I'm afraid we will be paying for it in years to come. Second, Europe. Now, as we know, and there are people from all over Europe, I suppose, in this session, the extreme right wing and neo-fascism have risen and arisen all over Europe. Parties which are not ideologically too far from Golden Dawn are either in government or in national parliaments. Now, what social trends have led to this development in a Europe that boasts about its Enlightenment legacy and values? I believe that globalized capitalism needs open borders and single markets, but this has led to permanent structural unemployment, huge inequalities, the delegitimization of the political system and political elites. People have felt humiliated, abandoned. The political leaders do not care about them. And this unraveling of social cohesion, this decline of the social state, has created a fertile ground for the social pandemic of fascism and racism. The right wing and the neo-fascists use economic, social, and cultural pseudo-arguments. The clash of cultures and the clash of civilizations. Economic, immigrants take our jobs. Social, they are culturally different in their customs, in their food, in their behavior. We cannot have them next to us. You may remember that Mrs. Thatcher famously or infamously said that I love Indians, but I cannot stand the smell of their food. Finally, Islam is presented as an existential enemy of the West and of Christianity. Now, how did these rather disparate ideas and claims combine? So number three and final, the psychology of hatred. In November 2016, members of parliament from Golden Dawn unleashed a torrent of racist attacks, abuse, and insults against refugees and immigrants at a meeting of the Parliamentary Committee on Defense and Foreign Affairs. They called refugees bogus, illegals, scum, people who treat the Greeks like Filipino maids and servants. Now, I was a president of the committee, and I had to stop the session to summon the parliamentary guard and expel the Golden Dawn, the fascists, the Golden Dawn members of parliament. Immediately afterwards, I was told that the incident had been filmed by one of the MPs, the infamous Kassidiaris, on his mobile phone, and already was circulated on the social media. The verbal and the physical violence and abuse were part of a media strategy, for which we have to admit Golden Dawn was quite successful. Now, I was rather bemused by the attacks on refugees. They were illegals, bogus, scum, but they also turned the Greeks into their servants and maids. Psychoanalysis helps identify two strategies in this type of racist ideology and psychology. The most common is a strategy that attributes all social and personal failure to a single cause: financial hardship, unemployment, social and moral decline, but also family dysfunction. Personal failures and frustrations are all the result of one single evil other. You can call it an irrational rationalization, which discovers a satanic presence, which is responsible and connects everything that has gone wrong, either for me or for my society. Today, this demonization of the other links the threat of disease, the pandemic now, and the need to defend the social or the political body with the refugee and the foreigner. So right-wing politicians have called immigrants insects, parasites, coming from scum places, and infectiveness, amongst others. Only yesterday, actually, I should comment that a right-wing Athens local councillor called the 17 November protesters of the day before cockroaches and rodents and rats. You have this dehumanization of the other, of the person you hate. And of course you remember, or most of us remember, that foreign sex workers suspected of being HIV positive were illegally and shamelessly exposed publicly in 2013, and two of them committed suicide after that. The then minister, Mr. Lovedos, claimed that they were a threat to the Greek nation because they transmit the disease to the Greek customer and through him to the Greek family. And recently, the creation of closed concentration camps on the islands for refugees was justified because refugees are a health bomb. And of course, this linking of the refugee, the foreigner with disease, particularly with coronavirus, is one of the most infamous, I think, racist tropes. Now, this is the first strategy, but there is also a second strategy, which is almost the opposite. It is based on the belief that the others steal our enjoyment, take our jobs and our benefits. Now, according to Freud and Lacan, as you know, civilization and each one of us is characterized by lack, by discontent. There is a discontent and unhappiness in the midst of our society. For the racist, for the xenophobe, this discontent is the work of those others who, despite their suffering, despite all the traumas they've gone through, they are still happy. They have better music and food. They have strong communities and good sex. They have lovable children. In other words, they have the things that we have lost. Hatred and envy become dominant emotions, either because of the imaginary inferiority or the imaginary superiority of the other. These are the psychologies of evil, and we must respond to them in kind, both with arguments, but also with confrontation. So I will conclude that the Golden Dawn trial will properly acquire full European significance if it were to lead to the creation of a new legal concept of crimes against democracy, to stand next and alongside crimes against humanity. If this then applied throughout Europe and stop new Golden Dawns from rising, then the trial will have been truly historic. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor.